When Hurricane Ike slammed into the Texas coast in 2008, it left $24 billion worth of damage in its wake. Not only were lives and property destroyed, but livestock and wildlife also suffered. One unseen casualty was underwater, the oyster reefs of Galveston Bay. 60% of the oysters in the bay were lost. In East Bay, 80% were destroyed. It's here where efforts to restore the reefs are underway.
We are in East Bay. We're actually between Bolivar Peninsula and Smith Point up in that area. After Hurricane Ike, there was a whole sediment layer and mud layer that was just put on all these reefs out here. And so by bringing back some material, then hopefully then we can get it back to the way it once was.
Tons of river rock will serve as the foundation for the restoration of this reef.
We are measuring the culch material, which is this river rock material that's going to go into the bay. This is very good substrate for when oysters, when they spawn, and their larvae will attach to this. This, we found, is very good material for that. And what we're doing right now is we're measuring to see exactly the width and the height and the length of all of this material. We put it into a formula to find out exactly how much cubic yards of culch material they have here on this barge. We measure each barge to make sure that we have the right amount of culch material out in the bay that we had asked for. We're putting down about 20 acres out on this side. Each barge load is about 2 acres. So this, what you see right here, is 2 acres of material put down. We put it down about 5 inches of material on the bay bottom.
With a little help from surviving reefs in the vicinity, the restored reef will rebound quickly.
What it will do is each oyster can release thousands upon thousands of larvae into the bay. They're free swimming. They'll come on over, and then when they find a good hard substrate, that's when they will attach and start growing right away. Normally, to get commercial size, you know, about 3 inches or so, it takes about 2 years, 2 to 3 years. On river rock, we found that talking to some of the leaseholders, they said that it takes a little bit less time, actually. They were looking at about 1 to 2 years. And this one, we're going to close for about 2 years. And at that time, we're going to allow the public to commercially fish it, part of it, at least.
New technology will help biologists monitor the progress of restoration sites.
The bay's never been mapped with side scan sonar before, so this will be a new and very powerful tool for assessing the condition of the oyster reefs and perhaps other habitats in the bay. So we plan to use it to collect baseline information on how much oyster reef is out there and what sort of condition it's in. We also plan to use it to sort of monitor restoration projects to see precisely how much acreage got restored after all is said and done, and to monitor how the character of that bottom habitat changes over time, because the oyster reefs will grow and hopefully expand, and we'll be able to capture that with the sonar information. This is the Biosonics DTX Digital Scientific Echo Sounder. The transducers are here. We have one pointing to the bottom and one pointing sideways. The bottom one is going to give us information on the depth and the character of the bottom habitat, and the one pointing sideways is going to give us information on the abundance of fish over those habitats. So together we're collecting data on fish abundance and bottom habitat simultaneously, which is pretty state of the art.
This is the image of the bay bottom that we're going over right now. You can see on the left, on the port side, there's not much reef at all, oyster reef, but on the starboard side, this is all oyster reef. You can see it kind of coming in through there as well. So this is the bay bottom that we're going over.
The funding for this project in East Bay comes from NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, through a federal appropriation for impacts resulting from Hurricane Rita. Additional restoration work that will take place this spring will be funded by a NOAA Fisheries Disaster Grant for impacts from Hurricane Ike. Another 2.5-acre site along the North Shore in San Leon, Texas, is being funded through the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, Texas Parks and Wildlife Department Kills and Spills Restitution Funds, and the Galveston Bay Foundation. This funding has allowed Texas Parks and Wildlife to restore oyster reefs and, with the latest side scan sonar, make new discoveries.
When we side scan and we find some really cool stuff, like when we find new reefs that nobody knew we had before, we're also finding that there's some reefs that were there that aren't there anymore. And then when we put it all together, you get to see stuff that not many people have ever seen.
Oysters are filter feeders and cleanse our bays by removing silt and contaminants from the water. Oyster reefs also provide habitat for a variety of organisms up and down the food chain. Recreational and commercial fishing generate an estimated $675 million to the Texas economy every year. More oyster habitat means healthier bays and more economic opportunity. There are also other rewards.
So this is kind of my dream job, building oyster reefs and scientifically assessing the success of the restoration process.
And this is a brand new project and hasn't really been done in Galveston Bay. I love restoring and bringing things back to maybe the way that they were at one point, or trying at least trying to.
This story will be included in an upcoming one-hour water documentary, Texas, the State of the Gulf of Mexico, premiering on Texas PBS affiliates in February of 2011. To view our most recent water documentary, Texas, the State of Flowing Water, visit our website, texasthestateofwater.org.